Hello students, today we'll be starting with a new chapter that is in your NCERT book. It is the chapter 5, that is the separation of substances. If you can remember, in the last chapter we had done about the sorting of the materials into different groups, that is we are dividing the substances according to the need into different groups. But sometime it so happened that different material mix together and we need to separate them out. Now, when we notice a substance being separated from a mixture of material, that time the methods we have to know very clearly which methods to be applied to which substance. In this chapter, you will learn this only. Say for example, when you make tea, you boil the water with the tea leaves, or tea leaves is soaked into the water, and after some time you have to strain the water in order to get the purified tea without the tea leaves. So that is also a method of separation. These methods you have to know here. Now, in this table, you have to know, or you will know, that why do we separate the substances. Say for example, number one is the separate stone from rice. It's a very common practice. You had seen that is a rice, especially to your mother, before making the rice, she generally often takes the rice in the container, and if impurities are there, any impurities, pebbles or stones, she used to pick them up. So what is the purpose? To separate two different but useful components. And what do? With the separated component, we throw away the solid component. The next example is the churning milk to obtain butter. Now, what is the purpose for which we have done the separation? To remove the non-useful components. And what do with the separated component? We throw away the impurities. And the third example is the separate tea leaves. As we were talking about just now, we have to remove the impurities or harmful component. And especially those who are familiar with the gardening process, you know it better, that these tea leaves are used as a very good manure. And obviously we know that tea is the main drink that we have daily. So both of these components, although they are separated, but serve the good purpose.